What up, world? It's your man Art back at you with another episode of You Dig. It's episode 4. Thank y'all for being here. This week, we're examining the hip hop legacy of Cash Money. We're going to run that back with two classic Cash Money albums. Then we're also going to discuss some positive actions going on in hip hop with Beyond the Mic. Then, of course, we're going to end things with another You Gotta Hear This. So sit back, relax. And let's get into some hip hop, you dig?
You dig?
You dig? Cause I'm all that in the sack. You dig?
My mama, I'ma put you in the mansion, you dig? The Cash Money records done made an expansion, you dig? Baby in the studio working like dogs, you dig? One day in the future, it's gonna be off, you dig?
I pull up on you and I pop at your key.
I'm in town, party's going down. Shoot 'em down with a 50 round.
You dig?
So now we're going to get into the legendary Cash Money Records. Founded by brothers Ronald Slim and Brian Baby Williams in the early 90s, Baby stated his reasons for starting the label. He was hoping to get them out of the projects and into a more positive way of life, and he wanted to help other people get out of poverty as well. In 1996, Cash Money began signing its slate of high-level artists. The artists included BG, Turk, Juvie, and Lil Wayne. These four artists formed the supergroup, the Hot Boys. There was originally a fifth member of the group named Bulletproof, but he left the group before they saw success and was killed in 2002. In 1998, Cash Money Records signed an unprecedented deal with Universal, which became known as the 80-20 distribution deal. Details of the deal included $30 million for pressing and distribution with a $3 million advance. Cash Money was entitled to 85% of his royalties and 50% of his publishing revenues, and ownership of all of his masters. After the deal, Cash Money began to see huge national success. Their first major release also came in 1998. Juvenile's 400 Degreez went 4x platinum and produced the timeless classic, Back That Thang Up. The album's release in 1999 also went platinum and produced memorable hits. BG's Chopper City in the Ghetto spawned the track Bling Bling, and Hot Boys' Guerrilla Warfare gave us tracks like I Need a Hot Girl. All of Cash Money's early albums and hits were produced by one man and one man only, the legendary Manny Fresh. Cash Money's success continued into the 2000s. Between 2001 and 2003, the label sold over 7 million records. This is with an 80-20 split. Label owner Baby Birdman Williams and Manny Fresh formed the group Big Timers. This group produced the label's first Grammy-nominated hit, Still Fly, in 2002. Around this same time, the label began undergoing unwanted changes when Juvie and BG left due to financial mismanagement. Juvenile returned shortly after his departure and gave the company its first number one hit with the track entitled Slow Motion. This track featured New Orleans legend Soulja Slim, who was murdered 4 months before the song was released. At this point, Cash Money basically went underground, and Mixtape Wayne emerged. In addition to the albums he released, Wayne dropped 18 mixtapes between 2002 and 2009. The series titles were the SQ series, the Drought series, and the Dedication series. By 2005, Lil Wayne was arguably the most popular artist in the world, and Cash Money rolled his success through the rest of the decade. In 2009, Cash Money signed Nicki Minaj and Drake to the newly formed Young Money Entertainment. Both these artists saw unprecedented success, further solidifying Cash Money's prominence in the music industry. For general perspective of Cash Money's dominance in regards to album sales over the years, as of March 2019, the label has accumulated over 130 album sales and gross revenue of $1.8 billion since 1998. Nicki Minaj is the only superstar currently signed to the label. In order to expand and remain relevant, Baby and Slim will have to rely on their ability to develop up-and-coming artists and help them navigate the changing music landscape. They're also going to have to modify some of their business practices. It's been noted that they won't pay you unless you sue them first, so that's definitely going to have to change if they expect to be successful moving forward. Cash Money legitimately dominated the hip-hop scene for a solid 20 years. Now we have to wait and see what they do with the next 20. Big shouts out to Baby and Slim and the whole Cash Money legacy, you dig? Yeah, yeah. Now we're going to run that back with two classic albums from Cash Money Records. The first album we're going to discuss is Lil Wayne's The Carter II, released in 2005. The first thing that stands out to me is the production. The first two beats are elite. The next thing to pinpoint is Wayne's delivery. Impeccable, man. I also think it's cool that they have two intros on this project. The Mob and Fly In are essentially intros, and both of them are fire. The next few tracks are singles, and honestly, my least favorite songs from the project. I love Wayne's versatility, though. His ability to navigate beats and find pockets where other rappers can't find them is amazing. I mean, that's what makes Wayne great. Mo Fire is straight fire. Then he hits us in the head with Best Rapper Alive. Crazy production, crazy delivery, definitely makes a case for making this song true. The following three tracks are all good songs. Then he hits us with Hit 'Em Up. Another album banger, another fire track. After that is another bar-filled interlude that kind of feels like the intro. Honestly, man, the track arrangement on this album is fire, man. Amazing. Right after that comes one of my top two favorite tracks from the album, Hustler Music. This is one of Wayne's top five tracks ever to me. Classic, Lil Wayne's Hustler Music. The next three tracks on the project are Wayne's personal tracks. I'm not really a fan of it, but I'm definitely big on art being therapy for the artist, so I'm with it. The next track to note is a Rakim flip entitled I'm a D-Boy. Cool track, and actually features a pretty good verse from Birdman. Next is More Heat entitled Feel Me. Wayne has been a professional rapper since he was 13 years old. This man's delivery definitely displays 10 years of work ethic and innate ability. Following Feel Me comes probably my favorite track, Get Over. This song is amazing, man, and will probably draw tears out of you on the right day. It's an awesome rap song, timeless art piece. Big shouts out to Wayne. Peace to you specifically for this song, my brother. The last track follows suit of the intro and interlude and is fire, capping a classic album. Yes, Lil Wayne's The Carter II is a classic album. My favorite tracks from this album would be The Mob, Fly In, Mo Fire, Best Rapper Alive, Carter II, Hustler Music, Feel Me, Get Over, and Fly Out. Lil Wayne's The Carter II, I'm going to give 4.5 gas masks. The next album we're going to discuss is Juvenile's 400 Degreez, released in 1998. The album opens up with an introduction from Manny Fresh, basically explaining what Cash Money and who Juvenile is. Track 2 was the lead single and a street classic, Ha. I love the authenticity and the rawness of this track. I would call this raw heat. Track 3, Gon' Ride With Me, is one of the best songs on the album. I love the production, love the hook, classic. It's one of those songs when you hear it for the first time, you gotta run back, you know? The next track is More Heat, but pause, man. Really, this album is 18 songs with only one or two near misses. Specifically, Follow Me Now and Juvenile on Fire. No complete misses, though. Plenty of heat, hence the title, 400 Degreez. So let's jump to the next track I consider classic. Welcome to the Know Ya, featuring fellow hot boy Turk, who killed it. Manny Fresh showed up with the high level anthem type beat, and Juvie showed up with another classic hook like he did so many times on this album. The next track, UPT, featured all of the hot boys and is fire. The album is really a group project led by Juvie. Everybody in Cash Money was responsible for the success on this one. Track 11, The High Remix, was actually my favorite song from the album when I was growing up. I love Turk on that second verse, man. I love the beat, crazy track, classic. Manny Fresh, amazing, by the way. Track 12 is More Heat. I love Wayne on that first verse and Manny on that hook. Track 13 is Back That Ass Up. Need I say more? Year 2045 classic. Track 14 off the top is Game and Street Knowledge that definitely brings balance to this project and was definitely needed. The next track, 400 Degreez is probably the best song on the album. Manny Fresh's production on this album is amongst the best produced albums of all time. Big shouts and much love to the legend Manny Fresh. The last song on the album is a high remix with a new verse from Juvie and a verse from Jay-Z in 98. More Heat, amazing album. The content on this album is not that diverse, yet every track feels different. Juvie's flow is elite, Manny's production is legendary, and the group effort on this joint is top notch. My favorite tracks would have to be Ha, Gon' Ride With Me, Welcome to the Know Ya, UPT, High Remix with the Hot Boys, Rich Ends, Back That Thang Up, Off Top, and 400 Degreez. Juvenile's 400 Degreez, I'ma give 4.5 gas masks. Word up. So with this week's segment of Beyond the Mic, we want to acknowledge some of the folks in hip-hop and some other art platforms that are doing what they can do to combat the spread of the coronavirus. So you know, it's a big topic right now, and it's definitely super important that we do address people staying at home and address people maintaining the quarantine. So we want to get into that now with Beyond the Mic. The first effort we want to acknowledge is Earth Day Live. That's on April 22nd. You know, Earth Day happens every year. This is actually the 50th anniversary of Earth Day. There are a couple of artists that are going to be participating to help spread the awareness of Earth Day. Of course, they're this year's Earth Day is specifically and putting a big focus on the pandemic that's affecting the Earth right now, of course. So Earth Day Live will be streaming live from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern on April 22nd, 23rd, and 24th. You can find this at EarthDayLive2020.org. They're also streaming on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Twitch. Some of the artists that will be involved with Earth Day this year, we have Questlove, Talib Kweli. There'll also be a few actors and a few thought leaders involved as well. So a really cool initiative that you want to check out, Earth Day Live 2020. The next initiative we want to discuss is Hip Hop Stays Home. That's actually an initiative being brought to you by All Hip Hop and All Deaf. They're encouraging people to use the hashtag Hip Hop Stays Home, showing people what they're doing while they're stuck in the house, cooking, playing with the children, Netflix watch parties, things of that nature. Just showing how and what you can do to enjoy your time at home with your family. Some of the notable people participating in this movement, T.I., Royce da 5'9 is participating, Just Blaze, MC Light, Chuck D, YSN Flo, a couple other people, Tokyo Jet, she's participating. Baron Davis is participating, so it should be a large scale event. Of course, this is hashtag Hip Hop Stays Home. So if you want to be a part of that, you can use that hashtag, and I believe All Hip Hop and All Deaf will be reposting videos. So yeah, take a look at that. Yeah, so that's this week's Beyond the Mic. Make sure you all are still adhering to the guidelines and staying home and doing what we can do to help prevent the spread of this virus. So that concludes another episode of Ya Dig. I hope you enjoyed our examination of Cash Money's legacy. Also took a look back at two classic albums, Lil Wayne's The Carter 2, Juvie's 400 Degreez. We also want to once again acknowledge Earth Day Live and Hip Hop Stays Home, hashtag Hip Hop Stays Home. So we're going to end this one with another edition of You Gotta Hear This. This one coming from our guy, Lil Wayne, off his debut album, 1999, The Block Is Hot, track called Lights Off. Big shouts out to Lil Wayne, big shout to Cash Money for all the material over the years, and big shouts out to you for being here, you know? So we'll end this one with Lil Wayne, Lights Off. You dig?
Cut the lights off, nigga. Cut them off. You know what time it is? What? You know what time it is? What? Strap up.
A lot of niggas better move out, cause here I come with my clique with the tools out. All of a sudden all these cowards on the spook out. It's walk, there a bunch of niggas about to lose out. It's time to load up them things. It's just
run in his thoughts and make him show us some things. Stick him in the room, go in his pockets and then blow up his brains. No matter the weather, rain, snow, sleet, or hail, I'm saying that matter. So tell the niggas in your hood to get it together. Cause I'm with Tude and Mario and be down for whatever. Never underestimate or you're going under. See, y'all gonna keep playing with Lil Wayne, but that little boy trouble. And plus the short if you fool, won't it be fun bundles? Him start wildin', hit the block and let his toys rumble. And it go batter, tatter. You be surprised that nigga scatter when the M1 shatter. And everybody on the block, they get about 10 in their bladder.
Tell them lights on, mask on, creep silent, lights gone. We done left the block quiet. Lights on, mask on, creep silent, lights gone. We done left the block quiet.
When it's time to ride, it ain't no time to play. It could be time to die at any time of the day. And I be goddamn it, if I let a nigga steal me, it will not happen. I'ma fire about 150 shots at him. And got my Glocks ramming, leave the nigga spot damaged. That's how to beat me up. Three blunts so I can get a head rush. Then come around the corner and your whole day crush. I'm sick and tired, niggas choose to test the water. They get hit and die. Some of them scared of manslaughter, so they stay inside. And watch their partners get lit up and then they ask why. That's cause you played with me. They couldn't have known I'm a gorilla. Drama stayed with me. Ran in his home, want to kill him, took his head with me. You better get it right or keep it right or lose your whole town. Tell them lights off, it's about to go down.
Thank you for watching, you dig. Please like, comment, and share this good information with your people. Also follow us on IG and Twitter at Rhymes Designs, and follow us on Facebook, Rhymes and Designs. You can find all the merchandise at rnd.com.
You dig?